faith we see the hand of God. In the light of creation's grand design. In the lives of those who prove His faithfulness. Who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning and welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. Hey, thank you so much for joining us. As we gather together, we focus in on the Bible. We read it. We discuss it. Moving close to Christmas time here in December 2021. I don't know if you're listening to us now live or you'll pick us up later, but it's December 2021. We read the Bible. We discuss it. We're thinking through the book of Colossians, Colossians chapter 2. Very important passage, I think, here at the conclusion of Colossians chapter 2, beginning in verse 16 down through the end of the chapter. If you'll read with me, I would appreciate it. Therefore, Paul says, do not let anyone judge you by what you eat or by what you drink, or with regard to religious festival, a new moon, celebration, or a Sabbath day. These are a shadow of the things that were to come. The reality, however, is found in Christ. Do not let anyone who delights in false humility and the worship of angels disqualify you. Such a person also goes into great detail about what they have seen. They are puffed up with idle notions by their unspiritual mind. They have lost connection with the head, from whom the whole body, supported and held together by its ligaments and sinews, grows as God causes it to grow. Since you died with Christ to the elemental spiritual forces of this world, why, as though you still belong to the world, do you submit to its rules? Do not handle, do not taste, do not touch. These rules, which have to do with things that are all destined to perish with use, are based on merely human commands and teachings. Such regulations indeed have an appearance of wisdom. With their self-imposed worship, their false humility, and their harsh treatment of the body, but they lack any value in restraining sensual indulgence. I love this passage because it says in verse 16, therefore don't let anyone judge you by what you eat or drink, or with regard to religious festival or new moon or celebration or a Sabbath day. Listen, we all celebrate different ways. We celebrate our faith. We live out our faith in Christ. And our hope is found in Christ. The reality of our lives and the foundation of our lives is the Lord Jesus Christ. We are rooted in Him. Now, we may express that differently. We may try different styles of worship. We may look in different ways of doing things. We may celebrate holidays or we may not celebrate holidays. We may get excited about certain aspects of, quote, the church calendar. We may not get excited about those things. Here's the deal. We shouldn't be judging anyone if we do. The point is, let's make sure we're all focused on Christ. Let's make sure we're all set on Jesus. The reality of our faith and the foundation of our faith is found in the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, here's the thing. We don't want to be judged. Don't let people judge you. Stand strong and say, you know what? I want to celebrate this way. I'm not worshiping the celebration. I'm not feeling I have to celebrate in this way. I enjoy it. That's the difference. Paul's talking to people later on. He'll talk to people who are coming out of Jewish faith and say, don't handle verse 21. Don't taste. Don't touch. Right? He said, don't get caught up in those human institutions. Right? If we depend upon those things for our salvation or our self-righteousness comes from the way we do those things, then that's a problem. But if you want to celebrate Advent, celebrate Advent. If you want to celebrate Christmas, celebrate Christmas. Let's do it in a way that brings glory to God, but let's focus in on the fact that it's the celebration of Jesus. Our hope is in Jesus, not in our celebrations. Because all of these things are destined to fail. All these things are going to die off, but Christ is the one who stands forever, and He's the one in whom we have hope. Now, listen, don't get caught up in people who tell you all kind of great things about themselves and how humble they are and how they've worshipped and they had all these great experiences. Listen, they've lost connection with the head of the body. Stay focused on Jesus and stay focused on people who, and stay surrounded by people who are focused on Jesus. Christ died to the elemental spiritual forces of the world. We don't need to submit to its rules. The rules that we find around us, religious rules and those kind of things, have to do with things that are destined to perish and based merely on human commands. And here's the deal, based on merely on human commands and teachings. So, for instance, right, some of us will not partake of alcohol. Others of us will. Some of us will not partake of tobacco. Others of us will. right? And when I grew up in the world, that was a distinction that was made. You true Christians don't do it, either one of them, right? But those things have to do with the body that will ultimately fade away. And we're not caught up on those things. They're based off merely human commands. They may be wise, but they're based off human commands and teachings. Regulations have an appearance of wisdom. They have an appearance of righteousness. But the reality of it is that they lack value in restraining sensual indulgence. So you may not indulge in one aspect, but you'll indulge elsewhere. What restrains sensual indulgence? The gospel, the power of the Spirit, the Word of God at work within us, a life lived in righteousness to Christ. The power of God that raised Jesus from the dead at work within us, that's what restrains sensual indulgence and a desire to live faithfully and repentantly before the presence of God. And so Paul says, let's focus in on Jesus. Let's grow our foundation on him. Let's do and celebrate how we want to celebrate. As long as those things aren't pulling us away from Christ, let's enjoy the lives we live, and let's recognize that our only hope for living a life of repentance and faith and restraint and self-control is by standing firm in Jesus and letting the Word of God and the Spirit of God work within us. Hey, you guys have a great day. We can put all kind of rules we want to us, but they don't have any power. What has power is Jesus. He's the one, and he works within us through his Spirit, and he empowers us to live lives of faithfulness. You guys go do that today. Be good, be good. We'll see you next time. That's tomorrow morning. Take care. See you soon.